Hi, today in this video we are going south of Missoula to the Bitterroot Valley, and we are going from Lolo all the way down to Darby. And if you weren't aware, the TV show Yellowstone is filmed down near Darby, so stick around to the end and we'll show you exactly where.
So let's take a look at the Bitterroot Valley from above. The Bitterroot Valley stretches from Missoula all the way down to Sula, and it is about 70 miles long and consists of seven main towns in the valley. And the first one we'll go through is Lolo, which is known for being a stopping point for the Lewis and Clark expedition. Also, if you take a right here at this point, you can go up to Lolo Pass and into Idaho, and you'll find Lolo Hot Springs up there, which is a great place to hang out. And that drive from Lolo up to the Lolo Pass is just beautiful. Lolo, the town itself, has got a population of 3,780 people, and it's 11 miles south of Missoula. And like I said, it's at the very north end of the Bitterroot Valley. Most of the towns in the Bitterroot Valley are very small, like Florence, which is the next town we come to, and it only has a population of 581 people, and there isn't much to it, but it's a pretty spot and beautiful views of the mountains all around. Which brings us to our next town, which is Stevensville, which is a very historic town in Montana. It was the very first town in the state of Montana. And right now it has a population of 2,025. And again, these are coming from a couple years ago, so I'm sure the population has gone up a little bit, but they're still pretty small towns. And as you can see, the downtown area is just it's like Americana at its finest, with the history and old buildings, and just a great spot in Montana and a place everyone should check out. We're starting to see a lot of newer subdivisions pop up around the Bitterroot Valley, like this one. And in this particular subdivision, they've had four sales over the past year of brand new homes, and they range in price from $339,000 for a 1,668 square foot house, three bedroom, two bath, up to $432,000 for a three bedroom, two bath, 1,930 square foot house. Another one of those great little small Bitterroot Valley towns is Victor. And Victor has a population of 753, has a historic downtown area, and it was founded in 1881. And as you can see, there's just great views to the west of the Bitterroot Mountains. One of the big draws of the Bitterroot Valley is the Bitterroot River that runs right through the center of the valley. And it's 84 miles long. It's a blue ribbon trout fishery, and it's known for the fly fishing opportunities, and you'll see people fishing the river all the time. And the river flows north and dumps into the Clark Fork River up in Missoula. And this brings us to Hamilton, which is the hub of the Bitterroot Valley, and it is also the county seat of Ravalli County. And the population in Hamilton now is probably over 5,000 people. The stats on the internet show it lower, but that was from a few years ago. Hamilton has been growing quite a bit over the last few years. It's a very popular destination for people. It has two different golf courses. One is private, called Stock Farm, and then they have a public one right in town. And again, Hamilton is kind of what you see when you look up the Bitterroot Valley. That's the town that everybody thinks about, and it's turned into the biggest destination part of the Bitterroot Valley. As far as the real estate goes in Hamilton, it's been just crazy over the past year. There's been 322 homes that have sold around Hamilton, and they range in price from the lowest was a $90,000 two-bedroom, one-bathroom condo that sold in downtown Hamilton, up to $3,600,000 for a 10,000-square-foot house that's on 3 acres in the Stock Farm Golf Club that I talked about earlier. The vast majority of homes that have sold in Hamilton have sold between $250,000 and $450,000. But as you can see in this subdivision, just spectacular mountain views, and Hamilton's just a great place to be in the Bitterroot Valley. Another great recreation area on the Bitterroot is called Lake Como, and it's located in between Hamilton and Darby, and it's got all kinds of trails. There's a 7-mile trail around the lake that you can mountain bike or hike. You can fish and water ski in the lake. It's just a great spot. So this brings us down to the southern end of the Bitterroot Valley in the little town of Darby. And what Darby is known for now is the show Yellowstone. And they've been filming it in Utah a little bit, but the majority of it is filmed right here in Darby. There's a ranch that's just south of town here, not even a mile south, called Chief Joseph Ranch, where they film the series. And the little town of Darby is kind of cool. It's got the Western, the Old West kind of vibe. And the ranch, like I said, is right along the highway. You'd never know it with the Hollywood magic that they do. The other thing they portray in that show is they make it sound like the ranch is right outside of Yellowstone Park, and that couldn't be further from the truth. Darby is actually a good 5-hour drive from Yellowstone Park, and all of the filming in the Bitterroot Valley makes you think that you're right near Yellowstone. So for those of you that have never been to Montana and love that show, I just wanted to give you a little look at what it's really like around where that ranch is. And like I said, it's a mile south of town, and you can see it right off the road. It's gated. I couldn't get in there. But as you watch here, it's right along a highway. And when you watch the show, you would obviously never know that. You can kind of see the barn from this side. So as you can see on the map here, it is just south of Darby. There's downtown Darby, and it's maybe a mile south of town. And you can see it, there's a gate right here that they have blocked off, obviously. And I was able to get in on this little road here, which is a private subdivision, and you can kind of see the barn, as you saw the photo earlier, just the back side of the barn. But when you Google it, the ranch, it comes up and shows you, you know, exactly what you see on the TV show. So it's also a place that you can stay. If you Google Chief Joseph Ranch, you can actually stay there when they're not filming. So if you like the show, it's a cool place to check out, and now you know where it is in Montana.
Thank you for watching our video. Please call, text, or email for more information, and don't forget to watch our other videos about Montana.